Okay. Let's start. ಓಂ ಸದಾಶಿವಸಮಾರಂಭಾಂ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯಮಧ್ಯಮಾಂ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯಪರ್ಯಂತಾಂ ವಂದೇ ಗುರುಪರಂಪರಾಂ. ವಿ ಎಂಡೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ನಹನ್ಯೇ ನಹನ್ಯತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಎನಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್, ಕ್ಲಾರಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್? ದಟ್ ಲೇಡಿ ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಟುಡೇ, ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎನಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್, ಎನಿ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್? 19th verse or clear?
We stopped at 18th also, isn't it?
I said we'll see the details later. Yeah, because look at it, he says the verse is very clear. Ye enam veti hantaram yascha enam manyate hatam. One who takes himself as the one who is killing, or the other person who takes himself as being killed, ubhav tauna vijanati, both of them don't get it, both of them don't understand. Why? Really speaking, the atma nayam hanti na hanyate, nayam hanti na hanyate, because the context is a battle, he is using the term killing, because the context is like that. Basically the question is atma a doer or not? You all have heard the term ahankara, ego. What is this ahankara? Aham karoti iti ahankara. What are you in the vision of the Gita? Nothing but pure consciousness. Everything else is adventitious. Something that's come, manifest, come and go. Reality is this. If I don't know that, what happens? This awareness, I, wherever there is a mind, the awareness will be manifest. Wherever there is a form, awareness is manifest, but as only as existence, like this table exists. It is not awareful. Table is not awareful. But if there is a mind in this table, then the table becomes awareful. Then I have to deal with this table. Hey, please, 1 hour, I'm going to talk. Don't disturb. Please sit. Don't walk around. Don't shake around. All these things are sitting on it. I have to now strike a deal. And the table can ask me, oh, okay, I will do that. What will you give me? I have to strike a deal with the table. Okay? But awareness is manifest as existence. It is not manifest as consciousness, awarefulness. Whereas wherever there is a mind, however rudimentary the mind is, yeah, it's on the door. However rudimentary the mind is, awareness will be manifest. Complex mind like a human being, awareness is manifest. Rudimentary mind like an amoeba, single cell, manifest. How do you know it's manifest? Because it responds to stimuli. It's alive. So what we call living and dead is only whether there is a mind or not. Now, when awareness is manifest in the mind, first thought naturally will be I am. What happened?
It's on mute.
You're getting a message that?
Yeah. I will take care.
They can't see you either, Swami. I think the camera is off.
Huh?
They can't see you either.
They can see, they can't hear. 1 second. Meet and chat.
I will take care.
Back. Yeah. More. No. Join audio. Call via device audio?
Yeah.
You're using device audio.
Now I have to keep all the audiences on mute.
Participants is muted anyway. All of them are muted.
Why I'm
mute all, hai na? Mute all.
Mute all,
yeah. Karan will be muted, okay. Yeah. Okay. So now look at this. Wherever there is a mind, the awareness will be manifest. Now when the awareness is manifest, remember the awareness is I. Now the I is manifest in the mind. What will be the first thought that is there?
I.
It has to be I. It can't be this. Because for this to come, I has to be there first. But does in the mind there is also ignorance about the I. So this I thought that is manifest doesn't know itself. It knows I am. It doesn't know what I am. Now when you know I am and I don't know what I am, it is natural to conclude, no? Because I have to deal with the world. I am, I look around, there is a world. Remember my story yesterday, last time, who was that Karthik Aryan, correct? It's temporary amnesia. He has to respond. So what will you do? On the basis of what you are identified with, because his mind is now manifest in a body and there are people around, on the basis of that you will make certain self judgments. Therefore you don't know what you really are, but you have certain concepts of yourself. This self concept is called the ahankara, the ego, the simple ego. Therefore anyone born, and all of us are born with ignorance, that's a capital. Look at it, a baby born today is ignorant of itself, is ignorance of the world. Doesn't even know what the mummy is, who the mummy is. It's only source of food and nourishment, warmth, love. It feels that. That's all it knows. Nothing more. And slowly in time, it sheds ignorance of the world, including its body, etc., to your mind, etc., to an extent. It sheds this as a process of social living. But that basic self-ignorance is there in the mind. Unless you address it directly by coming to a Gita class or a Vedanta class, that is not addressed. Therefore, all of us will have certain notions about ourselves. Basic, I am a human being. It's not a great conclusion, okay? I am a human being. I am male, female. Then brother, sister, son, daughter. So all these, Hindu, Muslim, if you are made aware of that early enough, Indian, Pakistani, American, whatever, all these are layers of self-judgment. I am responsible. I am carefree. I am extroverted. I am shy. All these are self-judgments. I am worried. I am angry. angry young man, even at 75. Angry young man. I'm peaceful guy. I'm peace loving. All self-judgment. Fat, tall, short, thin, good looking, not good looking. Why you're not good looking? Because I'm not fair. Only here, okay? Only in India. It is bad enough that they brought out a fair and lovely cream for women. They brought out something like that for men also. God, what happened to tall, dark and handsome? Judgments, all self-judgments. Can you see? This makes up your ahankara. But what is the fundamental ahankara? Indicated by the word ahankara itself. Aham karoti iti. I am the one who does things. I am the one who does things. Ahankara. This is the simple ego. This is not being egoistic. Egoistic is separate. Simple ahankara. Everybody has it. Mother Teresa, she was a saintly soul. Does he have an ahankara? Basic one was there. Saintly soul. She had a saintly ahankara. A wise person will have an enlightened ahankara. You will call the person a wise person. Because that ahankara is what helps that limitless consciousness that I am function in the world. So actually speaking, it was only a dress meant for functioning. Like your formal clothes when you go to work. You wear formal clothes. You won't wear casual clothes and go. There is a new term coming about. Smart casuals. It's an oxymoron. What is smart casual? It's a dress you wear for functioning. But I have taken the dress as myself. Can you see this problem? Therefore, what happens? That limitless consciousness that I am, the basis for this whole creation, now appears to be what? I am this much only. And if I have that notion about myself, two things I can never avoid. Now remember, I am a doer. So I do things. If I do things, others also do things to me. I do things to the world does things to me, natural. Therefore, everyone will have some guilt with respect to things not done, or not done good enough. How much that guilt is will depend upon the inner critic. That aspect of the ahankara that becomes critical, self-critical. It gets a name by itself, inner critic. In psychology, it gets a name. Okay? And hurt with respect to what others did to me. Guilt with what I did to others. Hurt with respect to what the world did to me. Everyone has it to varying degrees. Varying degrees. I'm helping people so much, they don't even care for me. They think of me only when they are in trouble. Someone came and told me, they think of me only when they are in problems. I said, good. Join the gang. Where do you think of sadhus, psychologists, doctors, etc.? Only when you are in trouble. I was very good. Join the gang, you are in good company. Isn't this universal? If you want to say, point out one thing which is universal, hurt and pain is universal. Yeah. That is ahankara. So Krishna dismissed the whole thing by saying, I am not the doer nor the receiver. Neither do I kill, nor am I the one that is being killed. The killed, because battle, the context of the battle. Yeah. So the term used is in that context. Not that we are warmongers, we are not. But in when we are involved in a battle scenario, we'll use battle language. If he was talking this to Radha and Vrindavan, he would have used different language. But the he was explaining to Arjuna here. Therefore, the language is current. I am nor the doer nor the receiver. I am not a karta in Sanskrit, nor a bhokta. Bhokta is one who receives. That means I don't do karma. I don't have karma phalam. Really speaking, the law of karma is not applicable to me. The law of karma is only applicable at the level of ahankara, the jiva. Big thing. Because there is no escape from karma. If you do something, you will get the result. It is your baby, Baba. It comes to you. You want it or not, you can't avoid it. That's why they say, be careful what you pray for. Your prayers will be answered. I don't want this. You prayed for it. Many of our prayers are like that. You want it after it come true. But you ask for it, it comes true. Therefore, you did it, you get it. Only at the level of ahankara, karma, karma phala is at the level of ahankara. At that level, it is true. Can't avoid it. Therefore, freedom from that karma. When you say freedom from karma, this is what you mean. Freedom from your sense of finitude. Freedom from being a doer and a receiver. Freedom from, in psychological terms, guilt and hurt. That freedom is only in the self. As individuals, meaning as ahankaras. Individuals means ahankara. Can we say we have done all that we are supposed to do perfectly? Anyone who has not done it, please raise their hands. I will raise both my hands. Why? Because I have not done it. Can you say you have never been hurt in life by what people did? Of course you can't. Natural, it's human. It's human. Why? Because I have taken myself to be a finite entity. What is that finite entity? This body, this mind. This is a dress I am wearing. Like the dress of the beggar that hero wore, that actor wore, the dress of the beggar for a role. Similarly, I came on this earth to play a role. I got so lost in the role. I got so lost in my own self-judgments. I have forgotten it's a play. And all human life is a tragic comedy. Again, oxymoron, but it is. It's tragic at one side, comic on the other side. Isn't this all our lives about? It's just a play. It's a role. So once you say role, remember one thing. That doesn't mean you can do anything and everything. A role has a certain script, no? It may be a very flexible script. Like roles today. The common role, husband and wife. The script is very flexible today, no? Previously, the script was more tight because the culture was like that. Very clear-cut division. Outside the house, you will take care of it. Inside the house, I'll take care of it. Very clear. The society was structured like that. Why? Inside the house, there was a lot of things to do. Then women got their freedom. How? Not because of feminist movements. That came later. The first freedom came with the electricity. Why? No more having to take the water from the well. No more firewood necessary. Can you see? With technological improvement, women find their chores are taking less time. There is greater freedom from the chores. Always chopping firewood, breaking water, all this big work. Huge work, takes a lot of time. So they stepped out to work. Change of roles. So the man better step in to help at home. So the script became more flexible. That's fine. Remember, this is like a Greek play where the audience is invited to be participants. You know? That's how the play is. So there's a great flexibility in the roles, great flexibility in the script, but some sort of a script is there. That's what you call your duties, responsibilities, just a script. How much etc. you decide. What is basic duty and responsibility between husband and wife? The word explains. Bharta bharyaha, Sanskrit. Bhru bhara, to nurture. So basic responsibility is what? Nurture each other. Everything else can be built upon it. Everything else is role playing, script. To nurture each other is basic responsibility. Oh, what a beautiful word. The word explains itself. What a beautiful culture. What are you supposed to do? Nurture each other. When you nurture each other grows. That doesn't mean you won't have a fight once in a while. Why? Because you have been brought together by the fire. And more important, there was Panigrahanam. You know what it signifies? Panigrahanam. You all did that now in marriage. Have you seen two boxers shaking hands? Before a call. Exactly. That's called Panigrahanam, okay? Jokes apart. Okay. I mean, these are all signals when you do. Signals. Yeah. Of what to come, of things to come, you know. You'll nurture each other, but you'll spar with each other also. All part of the game. Script. Flexible. Role. But if the real is missed, what will happen? The role is taken as real. And if the role is taken as real, all your problems will start. This couple got married on the stage. Role. Curtain down, applause, is that, etc. And the guy says, hey, now you better come home with me, you're my wife. There's only a stage wedding. Some idiots say you have to divorce also like that. That's idiotic. It's a role. Yeah. Similarly here, things are a role. But the role is taken as real because the real is not known. And if you know the real, it's a role, it's beautiful. You can play the role with all its beauty. Like an actor playing the role of a beggar. He will rival the real beggar. Why? Because the real beggar doesn't have background music for his song. Are you getting the idea? This is our life. Our life becomes tragic only because the real is missed out. Our life is beautiful. It's fun. It's great. Have a great time. Na hantaram, na hanyate. That's the thing. Neither the doer nor the receiver. I'm free. As a role, yeah. You apparently receive, you apparently give. And sometimes roles have its own little hassles up and down. That's okay. That's part of the script, part of the game. You remember, very flexible script. Some of it you write yourself. Some of it is given culturally. Some of it is given by the director. The order, that's called the order. That's there. Yeah. And you function. There's a problem in living. Living is not a problem. Living is not a problem. But Swamiji, I have so many things to do. Hey, you have a few challenges to take care of. Okay. That role, the role that you picked up is a hero's role, you know. Why hero's role? That's why you got so many challenges. Who has to face all the challenges? The hero has to face, na? Correct or not? So you're playing the hero's role. Okay, this is, any questions on this or this, the whole idea of not being a doer, this is important. I am not the ahankara. Ahankara is a dress I wear. So all rules, regulations, worldly or spiritual, you know, religious rules and regulations, all meant for the ahankara. Your mama telling you, you should get up in the morning and do Sandhya Vandanam. For whom is it? For one who takes himself to be the karta bhokta, the doer. Social laws, religious laws, all meant for the ahankara. Acha, Swamiji, that means if I study the Gita, I am free from all roles. Correct, you are free. I can go and kill somebody, no? After all, I don't kill. Correct. You don't receive also. So if they hang you, what's the problem? You kill somebody. Social law is that, the criminal law is that you have to be hanged for it. So let them hang you. You say, I am neither the killed nor the killer. Say it both all the way. If you say it all the way, you're fine. Can't be one way. Can you get the idea? It cannot be one way. It has to be all the way. Yeah. This is not a sanction for adharmic behavior. This is recognizing a fact that in the world there is something called dharma, rules, regulations, national law, etc. Whatever is the law of the country right now, I may not agree with it, but right now I'll follow. I can protest against it. Genuine protest is allowed as long as I'm not going and killing somebody. Yeah, a peaceful protest is part of a democratic setup. But the law of the land has to be obeyed. My protest cannot be inconveniencing everyone else for endlessly. Sometime, yes, otherwise the government will not listen to it. So some inconvenience, understandable, but not beyond a point. This is all dharmic functioning. Yeah. And if I break a law, I have to pay the price for it, make amends for it, what? All that is functioning. One level. And what am I really speaking? Limitless awareness is just a role. Just a role. What is the role you are playing now? Right now, teacher, Guru Maharaj. Vyasa Peeth mein baitha hu. Bahut acha. Moment class is over and I walk out. I'm your buddy, I'm your friend. I mean, come on. Ask the youngsters to walk with me. That's another role. Yeah. Atma does not play the role of a guru also, okay, permanently. I'm a grahastha, one role. I'm single, another role. I'm a sannyasi, another role. Think sannyasa is permanent? Another role. part of the ashrama dharma, one role. Everything is a role. Minimum, at the end of it, don't take yourself too seriously, okay? That's good. The understanding starts by saying, you don't take yourself too seriously, okay? It's all right, it is a role. Yeah, what you do, you are taking seriously and you are doing it, that's good. That's nice. That's good. Just a role. Yeah. So you have got so many responsibilities. It's a role. Let it lie lightly on your shoulders. It's a role, na? Amji, I am involved in social change, no? I see myself as an agent of change. Very good. It's so problematic. A role. It's just a role. What's problematic? Yeah, when you try to create change in the society, you're pushing against established systems. There will be a pushback. Natural. By people who've profited from the entrance system, there will be a pushback. How do you not expect it? So in that dynamic interaction, whatever new things has to come will come. Sometimes the interaction is sweet and smooth. Sometimes it's a bit problematic. It's okay. Part of the game. Sometimes it will involve a war like what they are going to face, the whole Mahabharata battle. Role? Are you getting the idea? Everything that you face in life is this way. That's what true freedom is about, isn't it? When you are living, whether there is birth afterward, they say technically moksha is no more rebirth and no more death after that. Dekha jayega. That's a way of putting it. Why? Because birth and death reveals your helplessness. You are not asked whether you wanted to be born or not. Karma dragged you here. Don't believe all the new age thing that you choose your parents, etc. It's a bluff. I'm sure half of us at least would say, I wouldn't have chosen these parents. At least 50% of the people here would say that. Yeah. And 50% of the parents also would say, I wouldn't have chosen children like this. 50%. Other 50% will be happy with it. So now you decide where you want to put yourself. Not for me to decide, for you to decide. So, birth, helplessness. Death also reveals your helplessness, no? It doesn't come by appointment, does it? It doesn't come by appointment. My mother had a tough time. She was 91. She said, when am I going to go? Every time I used to, she was staying with my sister at that time. When am I going to go? I said, I don't know, ask the Lord. Yeah, you should be able to tell me. I said, I can't tell you that. Even if I could, I wouldn't tell. Then she decided, I will not eat or drink. I will go. I said, you can. It's a choice available to you. It is not like swallowing poison. That is not allowed. That's adharma. But stopping eat and drink is within your choice. Because it's reversible. No? Anytime you want to start, you can start again. I said, but if your prarabdha is there to live longer, you will hang around for a long time, okay? Be ready for that. But she was firm. 3 months it took her. 3 months without food and drink, just this much of water every day. Water, milk, tea, everything together, just an ounce or two. You can't force death on yourself even if you want to. The other day, this guy got fed up. Nothing is working for him. So he drank poison. After some time, his eyes opened. And he thought he was in heaven. Why? There was bright light and a very beautiful face looking at him. My God, it is true. There is heaven. You are in Sion Hospital. I am the nurse in charge here. Didn't work. So, freedom from birth and death is a term used in the Shastra to indicate your helplessness. So, freedom from your helplessness. Because human life is like that. No? How often have we felt helpless? A lot of times.
Most of
the time. A lot of times. There are times I felt I should, if that helplessness was true, I shouldn't be here. I should have died. I wouldn't be here sitting and teaching. Yeah. It's good to have that. There's a time, at least that time you'll start thinking of God, you know. Yeah. That's true. Okay, now time is up, na? I should come there now. Time is up, okay, I'm ready. Hey, wait. You're supposed to suffer a bit more. Get out of this problem. Okay, fine. Are you getting the idea? Therefore, that sense of helplessness, etc., that is what samsara is about. Freedom from that is what? Only in understanding that you are this limitless awareness. Everything else falls short. You can temporarily alleviate a lot of things. Hurt and pain, this relationship, walk out of it. Temporary alleviation. Why? One problem gone. Then, other problem is waiting. What? Loneliness. That's waiting. Now I'll find somebody else. Swamiji, what to do? That character also turned out like this guy only. Hey, what to do? That certain karmic pattern there. Break that karmic pattern. For that we will do something else. We can. If there's a karmic pattern like that, we can break it. Unless it's by your choice. Then there's no karmic pattern to break. Then you have to examine why you're choosing like that. Don't blame everything on karma, okay? Where is your responsibility in it? So all this is the game of life. You as pure consciousness is free from the whole thing. Therefore, if you realize that, you can go through any hassles without a problem. Why? This lifetime I am playing tragic hero. That's my role this lifetime. Maja aayega. Maja aayega tragic hero, of course. This lifetime, my role has shades of grey in it. Because you know the truth. If you don't know the truth, the whole thing is a problem. That's like paying money to go and cry in a movie theater. But you'll enjoy it. Why? Because it's not real. Rula diya yaar, lekin maja. Rula diya lekin maja. ऐसा रोने के तो मैं आ जाना, मैं बहुत रुलाएगा तेरे को. That is not the question, okay? All right. Then the whole thing, he is putting up in a very nice verse, in the 20th verse, okay? न जायते म्रियते वा कदाचन नायं भूत्वा भविता वा न भूयः अजो नित्य शाश्वतोयं पुराणः न हन्यते हन्यमाने शरीरे न जायते म्रियते वा कदाचन. I me you, okay? न जायते is never born, न म्रियते never dies. What is born and dying? This body is being born. This mind in this body appears to be born. Correct? You, the consciousness, was always there. It's limitless awareness, unconditioned by time and space. So in you, the consciousness, your body and mind is born. therefore I, the consciousness, na jayate, na mriyate, nor is it dying. Because really speaking, where is death? I am consciousness, Rambo. Body. This has to go one day. This has to go one day. This is like what we say, you know, do you want to, how long do you want to live? I told you, one regret the Pandavas had when they went to the forest after ruling the whole kingdom for so many years. After the we didn't get a hero's death, we became old. We lived a hero's life, all right, but we are not lucky to get a hero's death. We became old. This Gandiva, he couldn't use it after some time. Can you imagine? Arjuna, the twang of the Gandiva made people shiver. Yes. Couldn't use. His time is up. Time for him to stop using the Gandiva anymore. Body. I think I thought we had muted the whole thing, but okay. Oh, that's not coming there. Whose phone is that? I wonder. Everything is muted. Somebody is not joined late and not muted. No, that's Arshan.
Sudha is on unmute.
Ah, that must be. She's joined in late, I think. Okay. Yeah. No, one person is not muted somewhere. She's still there. Yeah. This is the one that is not muted. Mute. Okay. Yeah. Thanks. Okay. So, na jayate mriyate va kadanchan nayam bhutva bhavita va na bhuyaha. Or having ceased to exist in a previous lifetime, he is born again in another lifetime. Because it is true, if you are born today, you must have had a previous lifetime. Because what is born and destroyed is only a body, nothing else. Your mind continues on its journey. Your sukshma sharira, all that terms I'll explain later, okay, keeps on being. From one lifetime to another lifetime, it goes on. Yeah. Are you finding this too much? Can we off this thing? Yeah. So please let us know if you're finding something disturbing, okay? Because I'm not bothered, whatever it is, okay. Yeah. Okay. So therefore, nayam bhutvana bhavita vana bhuyahan. Then what is the I? Ajaha, unborn. Nityaha, always there. Shashvatoyam Puranaha, I am Shashvata, always there. Puranaha. Puranaha is very particular. What is, by, normally you say Purana, you think something old, no? Pura api navam. That's called Purana. In olden days also it is new. Now, I'm hearing it now, no? It's new for me. Timelessness. Therefore, ajo, nitya, shashvat, all these words indicate what? Timelessness. Each word is dismissing a facet of time. Therefore, na hanyate hanyamane sharire. Sharire hanyate. Na hanyamane. Hanyamane sharire api na hanyate. Even though the body is destroyed, I am not. In other words, the whole verse is talking about you yourself as timelessness, unconditioned by time. Unconditioned by, when you say ajaha, nitya, etc., unconditioned birth means where is aging? Tell me literally, do you really age? Body does. Do you really feel old? In fact, I always tell the youngsters, you know, all the youngsters who are there. You know, for the first time, it got me, I was surprised at it. My father and his behavior at home used to be quite a serious person, you know. Not exactly someone who jokes and fools and. Then, as part of my marine engineering, I had to work in a marine workshop. So I must have been about 17, 18. So part of the training was in a marine workshop. And I'm seeing all people of my father's age there, behaving exactly like us youngsters here. You walk into any office. If a youngster walks into office, he'll see people of his father's age behaving exactly like how they behave. Haven't you seen that in your offices? Older people. Have you seen how your boss behaves at a party? Even though he tries to become a boss and be serious, etc. So where do you really feel old? Unless you're weighted down by too many responsibilities. Or you're judging yourself from the standpoint of the fact that your child has become an adult. Your child has got married. You've become a grandmother or a grandfather. Correct? Otherwise, your mind doesn't age. Your mind gets tired sometimes, yes. That I've seen in youngsters also, tired minds. Mind doesn't age. There's no aging, no death, no birth. That's you. The mind doesn't age. It can become mature or not mature. And the maturity of the mind is not age dependent. I seen very mature teenagers and very immature 80-year-olds. Yeah, I seen both sides. Or other way around also. Immature 18-year-olds and mature 80-year-olds. Mature 80-year-olds you don't have to mention. You expected to be at least mature by that time, if not wise. Now, what is maturity will become a big question, okay? If you look at it from a behavioralist standpoint, very often what is considered mature behavior is not mature behavior, okay? You are averse to taking risk, you are averse to being adventurous, all that is mature. If you really say you are mature, if you can't take risks, if you're a mature person, you should be able to take risks in life. No? Correct or not? How do you achieve anything without risks? If you're averse to risk, are you really mature? People don't think what is mature and what is not mature. And what is risk also changes. Ramji, I can't take that risk now. My potential for earning is not there. That is different. That's different. Yeah. Are you getting the idea that the whole, you have to think a bit on these lines, you know? Aversion to risk is not a sign of maturity. Foolish risk is also not a sign of maturity. Don't flip on the other side now. Therefore, the mind, you the consciousness free from all that. Timelessness is your nature. Body, of course body is meant to die. It has to die. I mean, even if you get spare parts, slowly starting for the body, you know. Heart transplant, liver transplant. And sure, with genetic engineering now, there'll be a lot of things available. 50 years from today, maybe. Maybe. 50 years from today, you'll be able to regrow certain organs necessary, etc. You know, cloning, etc. coming around. Using your own body cells, etc. Your heart is diseased. Grow a new heart using your own heart cells. The healthier cells that are there. Spare parts will be available. How long? Spare parts, eh, na? A time will come and you say, I want a new model. I've pushed this model as far as I can. Like your car. I've pushed this model as far as I can. Now I want a new model, the latest. time will come when you see, you yourself will see that. Yeah. Are you getting the idea? So body is meant to go, it meant to go. It's good. It's good it goes. Yeah. Okay, then he's highlighting this idea in a few verses. Similar, but all verses similar, but just highlighting the same. Veda vinashinam nityam. Yenam ajam avyayam. Katam sa purushav partha. Kam ghatayati hantikam. Veda, understand, he says. Veda here is to know, understand. Avinashinam nityam. Avinashinam, indestructible. Nityam, that which is always there. Enam ajam avyayam, unborn. Avyayam doesn't decline. It's important to note the difference. When you say nityam is always there, yeah, it's always there. But changing in time, you know. Changing in time. So now what has happened? Ab to bilkul buda hu, goli kha kar jeeta hu, ye halat ho jayega. No, avyayam doesn't decline. There is nothing like declining. Why? It is timelessness. It is not hanging around in time. Hanging around in time is not nityam. It is called continuous. Nityam is when time is not there, you are there. When time is there, you are there. Right now time is there, you are there. Dismiss time as in deep sleep, you are there. That is timelessness. Your own experience. Not some meditative experience of some monk sitting in the in Rishikesh. No, you. Dismiss time as in deep sleep, you are there. Yeah, that experience meant to show you. You are there when you dismiss time. Okay? Therefore, ajam avyayam katam sa purusha partha. That purusha. Puravushati iti. Purusha is a very beautiful term. The one who is manifest in this body is called purusha. One meaning. It's not male, female, anything. It is a pure consciousness. One is manifest here. And what is the nature of that purusha? Pureti iti purusha. That which fills up the whole creation. Because consciousness is limitless, no? That purusha. Katam sa purusha partha. Kam ghatayati hantikam. How can it get hurt or how can it kill? How can it cause injury? How can it kill? Yeah. Or whom does it cause to kill? Who is there other than me to kill? The character deserves to be shot here. Gole maro usko. Kisko? Is there anyone other than you? Who are you thinking of shooting? Can you see that? I am that limitless consciousness. What about you? Are you different from that? No, no, male limitless consciousness. Eh? This guy is a traitor. He is limited consciousness. Huh? Whether he is a traitor or not, let the courts decide. But can you see he is not limitless consciousness? That is not for the court to decide. That's for me to decide. He's also the same limitless consciousness. Are you getting the idea? There's only one limitless consciousness. So whom is there to kill? Somebody, I'll kill myself. Not possible. Not possible. You will destroy this body and say, oh hell, body is destroyed, I am there. Even as a jiva, you will say that. Even if you don't know your pure consciousness, you destroy this body. Then the jiva is ahankara. Okay, what is the jiva? Simple. You have a mind. You have your pranas, etc. The ability to see here, etc. The ability to function, etc. All that together is called the jiva. In brief, later on I'll elaborate what the jiva is. But in brief, this much. Your capacity to think, know, feel, act, receive information. This entity is called the jiva. And this entity is all mind-based. So consciousness is manifest there. Therefore, there is a sense of I, ahankara. that comes out of this body. That's called death. And what? Look at the one and say, oh my God, I'm not dead. But now, body is gone. I can't interact with the people around, but I am not dead. Yeah. Even the jiva doesn't die. Because for whom is karma, karma phala? Next time, for the jiva. Ahankara rumbar, the jiva. Karma, karma phala, everything is for that. If you knew your pure consciousness, you will remain as pure consciousness. But you don't know. Therefore, some more karma, because this is added to that. The added karma phala of destroying your own body. Added to your karma phala. Plus one. Yeah. Otherwise what? Who's there to kill or killed? I am the pure consciousness. So these are verses from different angles. He is looking at the same thing. How you are untouched. How you cannot be destroyed by anything in this world. You, the pure consciousness, is untouched by hurt, pain, guilt, karma, karma phala. Swamiji, you don't know me. You know what all I had done? Okay. You're done. Let us say, he was a serial murderer. And now he is repenting. That guy, is his consciousness any different from mine? For what he has done, there is karma, karma phala. For whom? The ahankara. The guy who is killed without remorse is now having that remorse, that guilt. Some evolution is coming into that mind. He has to face that karma, karma phala. Until when? Until he knows the truth about himself. Two levels. One, karma, karma phala at the social level, legal level, the law of the land. Other, karma phala in terms of Ishwara's order, karma, karma phala. Next lifetime, etc., etc., etc. Until when? He knows his pure consciousness. Then does it matter? The judge decides, heinous crime, he should be hanged until dead. Does it make a difference? The pure consciousness remains pure consciousness. The body that did all that thing, let it go. Achaiye. There is no reminder left in the society. So that people who face the brunt of his actions get some closure. The worst terrorist, consciousness is consciousness. Swamiji, so you'll go and give him a hug? If he's functioning as a terrorist, I will greet him with the point of my sword, with a gun in hand. Why, that's what he deserves. That's one form functioning with different form. That's functional. He's a terrorist. Shoot first, ask questions later. That's different. There's a role. That role, this is how it is. It's a role. Neither I am the killer nor he is the killed. And if he is faster, he kills me. Neither is he the killer nor am I the killed. That's also a fact. The difference is I know, he doesn't know. Therefore, he is hoping for his reward in heaven. Whatever his heaven is. I think he's in for a big disappointment. All these guys, when they go, they are in for big disappointments. Whereas I remain as pure consciousness because that's what I am. With the body, without the body, that's the only difference. That is the understanding. So the whole Gita is to make you understand this. Therefore, you'll find it being said from different facets, etc. From different facets, differences, it'll be said. Okay? Then the next verse will be said about little bit about your life journey in terms of birth, death, etc. That also will be there. So like this will go. Then he will dismiss all organs of destruction, all instruments of destruction as far as the self is concerned. All that will be dismissed. Okay. Yeah. Until your mind says, "Hare, that is true." Until your mind, which is free from any arguments against us, okay, they'll say, "Correct, I understood it. This is true." Clear up to now what we have done? We did only two verses, but that's enough because it's important. They're important things, okay? So more of it next class, okay? Om Tat Sat.